So let's have your number one, wherein we have our e of x is equal to x, yung d of x natin is equal to 4x squared plus 10x plus 16. Our c of x is equal to x squared plus 2x, and our f of x is equal to x cubed plus x squared minus x. Minus 8. So from this, we are tasked to get the limit of our e of x plus f of 0 multiplied by our e of x plus c of 2. Multiplied by our c of x squared minus 3x multiplied by c of x plus 3 e of x divided by x minus 12. So multiplied by our c of x, which is equal to, let's say c of x, okay, c of x divided by a value of f of x plus c of x plus d of x multiplied by c of x plus 4. So getting the limit of this functions, okay, as x approaches negative 2. So first things first is let us solve for f of 0 and c of 2. So take note that f of 0 is equal to 0 raised to 3 plus 0 squared minus 8, wherein f of 0 is equal to negative 8, and c of 2 is equal to 2 squared plus 2 multiplied by 2, we have a value of positive 8. Okay. So substituting it to our function. So substitute now yung mga value ng mga functions natin. So meron kang mga sagot na, or may makukuha kang mga function equal to x minus 8 multiplied by x cubed minus 8 multiplied by, so our e of x is equal to x cubed, okay? So x cubed minus 8 multiplied by x cubed plus 8, so multiplied by our x squared plus 2x squared minus 3x multiplied by x squared plus 2x plus 3x cubed all over x minus 12. Yan. So multiplied by our c of x, which is equal to x squared plus 2x. Okay? So guys, yung e of x natin, x cube ba? Yun yung nasa sit work natin. So divided by our f of x, which is equal to x cubed plus x squared minus 8. So lagyan ko ng close and open parenthesis for f of x. To our c of x, we have x squared plus 2x plus yung d of x natin, which is equal to 4x squared plus 10x plus 16. So close and open parenthesis multiplied by yung c of x plus 4 natin, which is equal to x squared plus 2x plus 4. Okay. So getting the limit at x approaches negative 2. So from this equation, actually marami kayong pwedeng gawin dito, but probably ang pinakamagandang gawin muna is ito. Okay, so pwede mo siyang i-expand, pwede mo siyang i-factor. Okay, but probably ang pinakamagandang gawin dito is factor mo. Okay, wherein we have a value of x squared plus 2x squared, tama, minus 3x multiplied by x squared plus 2x plus 3x squared minus 12. Okay, so focus on this equation muna. So you can see that we have x squared plus 2x. So take note that this can be factored by x multiplied by x plus 2 squared minus 3 x squared. X squared or x plus 2. Okay. So x plus 2 squared minus 3x. So multiplied by, so pwede natin factor or yung x dyan, so we'll have a value of 3x squared multiplied by x plus 2. Ayan. So plus, take note that can we factor yung 3 natin, pwede na natin ilabas, meron kang value ng 3 x squared minus 4. So from that, you'll have a value of x squared multiplied by x plus 2 squared. Okay, parehas lang yan, no? So x squared multiplied by x plus 2 squared minus 3x squared multiplied by x plus 2 plus 3 multiplied by x plus 2 multiplied by x minus 2. Ayan. So, makikita mo na yung pinaka-common dito is yung x plus 2. So, therefore, factor out your x plus 2, you will have a value equal to x plus 2 multiplied by x squared multiplied by x plus 2 minus 3x squared plus 3 multiplied by x minus 2. Tama ba? So, also, from this, pwede mo na siyang gawing x plus 2 multiplied by x cubed plus 2x squared minus 3x squared plus 3x minus 6. So, also, we'll have a value of x plus 2 multiplied by x cubed minus x squared. So, from this, plus 3x minus 6. Okay? So, let's say that would be our first factor. So, from that, you will have a value of ito na. So, equal lang to, ah. Okay? Yan. So, also, we can already factor these terms because they are special product. They can be just rewritten as x minus 2. So, x cube minus 2 cube and x cube plus 2 cube. Okay? Special product. So, therefore, we can have a value equal to x minus 2 multiplied by x squared plus 2x plus 4 multiplied by x plus 2 multiplied by x squared minus 2x plus 4. So, syempre multiply natin yung na-factor natin kanina. We have x plus 2 multiplied by x cubed minus x squared plus 3x minus 6. So, multiplied by, so factor na lang na din natin to. We have x multiplied by x plus 2. Okay? So, divided by to. Gawin natin to, guys. We have x cubed plus x squared. Wala. So, this will be automatically x cubed. Yad natin, no? Plus, we have x squared plus x squared. We have 2x squared plus 4x squared. We have 6x squared. And then, we have next, we have negative 8 plus 16. So, we have positive 8. And, of course, yung 2x plus 10x natin, we have positive 12x. Okay? So, multiplied by x squared plus 2x plus 4. So, from this equation, we can easily cancel out this value because they are equal, tama? So, x squared, yan, 1 lang yan. Okay? So, next is actually we will try to solve the problem still. Okay? So, pwede na ba tayo mag-substitute ang negative 2? Try nyo mag-substitute ang negative 2 dito. Basta hindi maging 0 sa baba or sa taas, okay na. Okay? But in this case, kasi pag nag-substitute ka ng negative 2, you can see na negative, pag nag-substitute ka ng negative 2 dito, 0 yan. So, nag-substitute ka ng negative 2 dito, 0 to. Okay? So, meaning, from law of our roots, law of roots, pag nag-substitute ka, negative 2 is 0. Ibig sabihin, there's a possibility. Or there is a tendency na itong, kwan na to, itong root na to is at equal to x plus 2. Okay? So, gawin natin. So let's try to factor this x cubed plus 6x squared plus 8 plus 12x. So how will we do it? Take note that we can solve it by factoring x cubed plus 6x squared plus 12x, or write ko na siya, plus 8. So how will we factor? So pwedeng by substitution ka nga, pag nag-substitute ka ng f of positive 2 or f of negative 2, you will have a value equal to 2 raised to 3 plus 6 multiplied by negative 2 squared plus 12 multiplied by negative 2 plus 8, you will have a value equal to 0. So therefore, possibility, negative 2 is a root. So therefore, we have a value of x plus 2. Okay? So pwedeng maging volume is x plus 2. So how will we prove that one? Basically by factoring. So by grouping muna tayo. I-group natin to. Meron kang x cube plus 8. Nakagroup yan sa plus 6x squared plus 12x. Group mo yan. Okay? Parehas pa rin yan, tama? Associative property of addition. Okay? So take note that x cubed plus 8 can be factored into x squared x plus 2 multiplied by x squared minus 2x plus 4 special product plus factoring out your 2x, you will have a value of factoring out your 6x, I should say, meron kang value na x plus 2. Tama ba? So pag multiply mulit dyan, meron kang 6x squared. Pag multiply mulit dito, meron kang value ng 12x. So factoring out your x plus 2, because they are common here, so we'll have a value of x plus 2 multiplied by x squared minus 2x plus 4. Okay? So plus our value of 6x. So from this, you will have a factor of x plus 2 multiplied by x squared plus 4x plus 4, which is equal to x plus 2. So this is special product, so take note that it is x plus 2 squared. So therefore, our denominator can be expressed as x plus 2 raised to 3. Okay? So from this, so since meron tayo na-express, so write natin yung values natin. So we'll have a value of x minus 2 multiplied by, so naka-cancel na to kasi 1 lang to na itong mabang yan. So x minus 2 multiplied by x plus 2 multiplied by ito, yung x squared minus 2x plus 4. Okay? So multiplied by our x plus 2 multiplied by x cubed minus x squared plus 3x minus 6. Okay, so multiplied by x plus 2, so of course divided by our x plus 2 raised to 3. Ito yun, no? So ito yung factor niya. Okay? So as you can see, hanapin natin yung mga x plus 2 dito. Magkong isang x plus 2. So x plus 2 multiplied by x plus 2, x plus 2 squared multiplied by x plus 2, you will have a value of x plus 2 raised to 3. So divided by x plus 2 raised to 3, 1 lang yan. So by further manipulation of the equation, you will have a value of x minus 2 multiplied by x squared minus 2x plus 4 multiplied by x cubed minus x squared plus 3x minus 6 multiplied by x as the limit of x approaches negative 2. Okay? So from this, we can get the limit wherein we'll have a value of negative 2 multiplied by negative 2 multiplied by negative 2 squared minus 2 multiplied by negative 2 plus 4. Okay. Multiplied by our negative 2 raised to 3 minus negative 2 squared plus 3 multiplied by negative 2 minus 6 multiplied by negative 2. Okay. So from this, or lagay nyo na lang sa calculator nyo yung alpha x minus 2 multiplied by alpha x squared minus 2 alpha x plus 4 multiplied by alpha x raised to 3 minus alpha x squared plus 3 alpha x minus 6 multiplied by alpha x. So calc negative 2, you will have a value equal to negative 2304. So this is the value of the limit. Okay. So medyo mahaba-haba siya, guys, no? But patience and skills are the virtue. Okay? So, yun yung sagot natin. So, number 1, negative 2304. If you will have any question, screenshot nyo lang, tapos underline na nyo lang yung gusto nyo tanongin sa akin, I will be answering. Okay? Pag nakita ko. So, that's number 1. Okay. So let's solve our number 2. We have the limit of 4 sine theta over 2 multiplied by cosine theta over 2 multiplied by cosine theta all over 2 plus sin theta all over 2 multiplied by cosecant theta all over 2 multiplied by secant theta all over 2 minus cosecant theta all over 2. So nasa loob yung mga yan, no? Multiplied by secant theta all over 2 divided by secant theta all over 2 multiplied by cosecant theta all over 2. So divided by the limit of 1 minus sin pi over 2 multiplied by cosine pi over 2 multiplied by second theta cosine theta over 2, okay, sine theta over 2 multiplied by cosine theta over 2 multiplied by second theta over 2 plus square root of second square theta minus 1 all over second theta. So yung limit nito sa punta sa pi, and then yung limit ng whole sa punta sa 0. Okay. But probably, if you would analyze the equation, okay? So, dito pa lang, 0 na to. Okay? 0 na yan. So, wala ka ng ibang gagawin nyo kundi 0 na agad yung nasa task mo. Hindi mo naman siya pwedeng i-manipulate kasi pag binanipulate mo siya, magkakaroon ka ng value ng 1 minus 1. Okay? 0, tama? So, therefore, ang pwede lang natin ngayong i-manipulate is yung nasa baba. So sana hindi rin siya maging 0. Kasi pag nag-substitute ka ng value ng pi dito, ng pi over 2. So 1 minus sin shift pi over 2. Okay? Multiplied by cosine shift pi over 2. You will have a value of 1. Okay, 1. And then of course, pag nag-substitute ka ng 1, pag 1 pa rin dito. So therefore, 0 yung sagot. So 1 all over cosine shift pi plus square root of 1 all over cosine shift pi squared. Okay, so minus 1. Okay. Pag 1, ito ibig sabihin siya rin sagot. Okay, negative 1. Okay, so negative 1 divided by 1 over cosine chi pi. 1. So 1 divided by 0. 0 yung sagot dito, guys. Okay. So from there, we have 0. So ito na lang yung manipulate natin. Okay. Ito yung manipulate natin, no? So you can see that this is equal to 1 minus sine pi over 2. 2 sine pi pala to. So 2. 1 minus 2 sine pi over 2 multiplied by cosine pi over 2. So you can see that this is just an identity of your sine to u. Okay? When we have your u is equal to theta over 2. Therefore, we have a value of sine 2 multiplied by theta over u. So meron kang theta over 2. So meron kang value ng sine theta. Ayan. So therefore, take note, theta to, hindi yan x, theta to. So honest mistake yan. So therefore, we'll have a value of 1 minus sine theta. Okay. So this one is equal to this one. So 1 minus sine theta multiplied by, take note that secant theta can be rewritten as 1 all over cosine theta plus yung square root ng second square theta is equal to cotan, tama? Cotan square theta divided by second theta. So parang siya naging cotan, so punta ka dito, sec tan sin. We have cosec, cotan, cosin. Okay. So tan pala to, tan. So tan yan. Tan squared theta. Okay. So tan squared theta. Ayan. Sorry. So from that, you can see that itong cosine theta mo is just equal to, so 1 all over cosine theta plus square root of tan squared theta divided by 1 over cosine theta, no? So pwede mong sabihin na 1 all over cosine theta, so divided by 1 all over cosine theta plus our square root of tan squared theta is equal to tan theta. Tan theta divided by 1 over cosine theta. Ayan. So therefore, 1 cosine theta divided by 1 cosine theta, meron kang value ng 1 plus tan theta multiplied by cosine theta. So take note na itong tan mo, may identity yan, which is equal to 1 plus sine theta all over cosine theta yan. Tama ba? Note that tan theta is equal to sine theta all over cosine theta. So multiplied by cosine theta later on. So magkakaroon ka ng value ng 1 plus sine theta. Ayan. So from this, ito pala equal dito, no? So since equal yan dyan, take note na meron kong value ng 1 plus sine theta, no? So getting the limit of this one. So limit as theta approaches pi. So take note na multiply natin yan, meron kong value ng 1 minus sine squared theta. So since meron kong sine squared theta, we have the limit of, take note that 1 minus sine squared theta is just equal to, so dito break tayo sa 1 natin. So sin cos. Okay, ito yung 1 natin pag kinuha natin yung square niya plus, so we have sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1, which means that your cosine squared theta is equal to 1 minus sine squared theta. So meron, ito yung paparehas niya, therefore we'll have cosine squared theta as theta approaches pi. So therefore the limit of cosine squared theta as theta approaches pi is equal to cosine squared pi, which is equal to cosine pi is equal to, so cosine chi pi is equal to negative 1 squared, so we'll have a value of positive 1. Kasi yung pi natin, pag kumuhit ka ng unit circle, eh, ito yung 0 mo, ito yung pi mo, which is equal to 180 degrees. So from that, pag kinuha natin yung limit ng buo, kunin mo yung the limit of 0 all over 1 as theta approaches 0, so therefore 0. Yan yung sagot. Ayan. Ng ating number 2. Okay. So let's solve our number 3. Wherein we have the limit of x squared plus 2 multiplied by square root of x minus 2 divided by the cube root of the cube root of x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1 multiplied by square root of x squared minus 4. Okay, as the limit of x approaches infinity. So pag ganyan, mapapansin mo guys na medyo mahirap, no? Simplify muna natin. So take note that this can be written as x raised to 9 plus 2 raised to x plus 1 raised to 1 third raised to 1 third. Okay? Which can be written as x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1 raised to 1 ninth, which means it is equal to the ninth root of x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1. Okay? And also, this can be factored out into, note that the square root of x squared minus 4 can be factored out into square root of x plus 2 multiplied by x minus 2, which means it is equal to square root of x plus 2 multiplied by square root of x minus 2. Okay. So therefore, from this, we may say that we have the limit of x squared plus 2 multiplied by square root of x minus 2 divided by ninth root of x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1, so multiplied by square root of x minus 1 multiplied by square root of x minus 2, I should say, multiplied by square root of x plus 2 as the limit of x approaches infinity. Okay, so as you can see that we have square root of x minus 2 ka-cancel out yan, so we'll have a value of x squared plus 2 divided by the ninth root of x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1 multiplied by square root of x plus 2 as the limit of x approaches infinity. Okay, so wait lang, tanggalin natin tong isa. So tanggal natin to hanggang dyan lang yan. Okay, so ibala pa yung square root of x plus 2 natin. Ayan. So therefore, from this, kung nag-substitute ka ng value ng limit of infinity agad, magkakaroon ka ng value na infinity divided by infinity. Okay? So best thing is gawin natin, mag-multiply tayo ng value. Okay? So pag kinuha natin yung 9th root of square root of 9, you will have a value equal to x. Okay? Pag kinuha naman natin yung value ng square root of x, you will have a value of x raised to 1 half. So, mapapansin nyo, pag pinag-add nyo yung value na yan, you will have a value of x raised to 1.5, tama? So, tignan nyo yung nasa taas natin, yung numerator natin, you have a value of x squared. Okay? So, di ba lagi nating sinasabi kung ano lapa yung mas mataas, yun yung gagamitin. Okay, so in this scenario, mas mataas yung x squared natin kaysa sa pinagsamang value ng x raised to 1.5, o yung x at x raised to 1.5 natin, which means that we will use our x squared. So therefore, from this scenario, you can have a value of x squared plus 2 divided by the 9th root of our x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1. Okay, so multiplied by our square root of x plus 2, so multiplied by 1 over x squared divided by 1 over x squared. Okay, so actually guys, pinakamaganda ang pwede nyo rin gawin dito is expand nyo to. So pag samahin nyo silang dalawa pa expansion, pero masyadong mahaba kasi kukunin mo muna yung GCF nya and then gagawin mo sa isang radical which is nasa 18th root. Okay, and then kukunin mo yung square root ng ating i-square mo yung x raised to 9 plus 27 and then i-11th root mo yung x plus 2. Okay, or gawin mong 9th root ng x raised to 9th root ng x. Bale, magkakaroon ka ng value ng pinakamataas na x mo is 2 18 plus 9, 27. Okay, so 27 divided by 18, you will still have a value of x raised to 1.5. okay, so mas mataas pa rin yung x square mo. So therefore, gawin na lang natin agad na ganito para hindi ka na mahirapan na mag-expand. Okay, so since from this we'll have a value of x squared divided by x squared plus 2 all over x squared, so divided by, so pwede mong i-distribute yung x mo dyan, so meron kang value ng 9th root of x raised to 9 plus 2x plus 1, so divided by x, yan, multiplied by square root of x plus 2 divided by x. So mapapansin mo x multiplied by x is still x squared. Okay, 1 pa rin yan. So from this you will now get the its limit as x approaches infinity. Ayan, so therefore we'll have a value of the limit of 1 as x approaches infinity plus the limit of 2 all over x squared as x approaches infinity divided by yung limit natin ng limit ng ating 9th root. Okay, so 9th root of x raised to 9, so take note that the value of x at 9th root is equal to x raised to 9 is equal to our 9th root of x raised to 9. Okay, so x is equal to the 9th root of x raised to 9, so therefore magiging 9th root yan, so divided by x raised to 9 plus 2x divided by x raised to 9 plus 1 all over x raised to 9. Okay, may value yan, so multiplied by the limit of ito, pag x is also equal to square root of x squared, pag pinasok mo sa loob ng square root, so we will have a value of x divided by x squared plus 2 divided by x squared. Okay, so as x approaches infinity, so take note that this value will have a value equal to 1 plus 0 divided by, this value will have a square root of 1 multiplied by square root of, so 0 to, so multiplied by 0, so meron kang value na 1 all over 0 which is equal to infinity, so infinity yan. Okay, number 4. Let's solve the limit of 1 plus x raised to 1 over x minus 1 multiplied by the limit of 1 plus x raised to 1 over x minus 1 divided by 25 raised to x plus 2 multiplied by 5 raised to x plus 1 multiplied by e raised to x times e raised to x minus 1. So also may multiplied by e raised to ln of 5 raised to x plus 1 as a limit of x approaches 0. Okay. So from this we can have a value of, take note that this is just e and e, tama. So pag meron tayong x approaches 0 dito, x approaches 0, okay, so that is just e. Okay, so therefore we'll have a value of e minus 1 multiplied by e plus 1 multiplied by e raised to 5 raised to x is ln of 5x is just equal to 5x, tama, plus 1. So para nangyari yon, so from the row of logarithm we're in, b raised to log of b, log of a raised to u to the base b is just equal to a raised to u, same base, no, kasi nga itong ln mo is equal to log of e. Okay, log of a to the base e. Okay, yung a of u mo dito will be equal to 5 raised to x. Okay, so divided by our, take note that 5 raised 25 raised to x can be written as 5 raised to 2x plus 2 multiplied by 5 raised to x plus 1, so multiplied by e raised to 2x minus 1 law of exponent yan. So this is a special product rule wherein we have a value of 5 raised to 2x plus 1 squared. Okay. So therefore, by further manipulation of this equation, we will have a value of e squared minus 1. So e squared minus 1, e minus 1 multiplied by e plus 1 multiplied by 5 raised to x plus 1 divided by 5 raised to x, okay, divided by 5 raised to x plus 1 squared multiplied by e raised to 2x minus 1. Okay, so okay, so ito 5 raised to x yan kasi nga yung a mo dito, yung a mo dito is equal to square root of 5 squared x or equal to 5 raised to x yan. Tapos yung b mo dito is equal to 1. So from the special product of a plus b squared, so meron kang value na a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So since yung a mo is equal to square root of 5 squared x, so 5 squared, yung a mo is equal to 5 raised to x, so therefore 5 2x plus 2 multiplied by 5 raised to x multiplied by 1. Okay, so plus yung b mo is 1 squared, so plus 1. So mapapansin mo pareha sila. Okay, so hindi mo pwedeng i-combine to, no, kasi hindi sila parehas ng base. Okay, so from this you will see that you will have a value of e raised to 2 minus 1 divided by e 5 raised to x plus 1. So magka-cancel out yung isa kasi magiging raised to 1 yan. Raised to 1 multiplied by e raised to 2x minus 1. Okay, so take note that you will get the limit of e squared minus 1 divided by 5 raised to x plus 1 multiplied by e raised to 2x minus 1 as x approaches 0. So take note that this e is a constant yan. So constant to. So e squared minus 1 divided by 5 raised to 0 is 5 raised to 0 is 1, okay? 1 plus 1 multiplied by e raised to 0 minus 1. Ayan. So therefore, we'll have a value of e squared minus 1 divided by 1 minus 1. So any number raised to 0 is always equal to 1. So therefore, we'll have e squared minus 1 divided by 0. We'll have a value equal to infinity. So infinity yung sagot dyan. So let's have the limit of ln of x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x squared divided by x plus 3 squared minus 9 multiplied by x plus 2 divided by log of x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x squared divided by x plus 3 squared minus 9 multiplied by x plus 2 as the limit of x approaches 1. So parehas lang yung kwan ito, yung mga equations sa loob ng ating numerator at denominator. So the first thing to do here is ito muna. So simplify natin siya. So we have a value of x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x squared divided by x plus 3 squared minus 9 multiplied by x plus 2. Okay. So the first thing that we need to do is to expand our denominator. Okay, so we'll have a value of x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x squared divided by x squared plus 6x plus 9 minus 9 multiplied by x plus 2. Okay, so we'll have a value equal to x raised to 4 plus 8x cubed plus 12x squared divided by x squared plus 6x. So 9 minus 10 is 0. So multiplied by x plus 2. Okay. So from this, you can already see the how will we answer the problem. So probably, pag naglabas ka ng x squared dito, mayroon kang value na. So x squared multiplied by x squared plus 8x plus 12. Okay, so pag naglabas din tayo ulit dito ng, let's say, x. Okay, so we'll have a value of x plus 6 multiplied by x plus 2. So take note that if we would factor our numerator ito, so we'll have a value of x plus 6 multiplied by x plus 2, tama? So 2 times 6, 12, 2 multiplied by x, 2x, plus 6 multiplied by x is 8x. X multiplied by x is equal to x squared. So therefore, magka-cancel lang to kasi 1 lang to. Okay? So we'll have a value then is equal to x. So therefore, from this, we'll have a value of, since parehas ito at parehas to, okay, we'll have a value of ln of x divided by log of x as the limit of x approaches 1. Okay. So, change of base tayo para you can, kasi pag parehas yung base niya, parehas, hindi parehas yung kanya, yung logarithm niya. So, natural at common, hindi pwedeng kunin. Okay. Actually, pwede siya pag directly na pag nag-substitute ng value dito, we'll have a value of 0 over 0 kasi siya, which is indeterminate. Pero pag nagkaroon ng value, okay na sana yan. Since indeterminate yan, so ang gagawin natin is mag-change of base tayo. Well, let's say, y is equal to ln of x. So e, so y is equal to log of x to the base e. So pag release mo yan, e raised to y is equal to e raised to log of x. So property to the base e of base raised to log of u to the base b is equal to u. So therefore, we will have a value of e raised to y is equal to x. So from this, pag kinuha natin yung log niya, so log e of y is equal to log of x. So therefore, we'll have a value of, so take note na property yan ng logarithm natin, yung exponential property, y log of e, therefore is equal to log of x. But what is y? So take note that our y was defined a while ago as ln of x. So therefore, ln of x multiplied by log of e is equal to log of x. So therefore, our ln of x is equal to log of x divided by log of e. Okay? So from this, pwede natin i-substitute yung value ng ln of x mo dito. So therefore, we will have the limit of yung ln of x mo is log of x divided by log of e divided by log of x as the limit of x approaches 1. Okay, so from this you will have a value of, so makakancel yan kasi 1 lang yan, so we will have a value equal to the limit of 1 all over log e as x approaches 1 or equal to 1 over log e, which is equal to 1 over log e (2.30258), okay, or approximately equal to ln 10.